So how do you feel about what's going on Wall Street now?
Let me just phrase this way. Crime in the U.S. has been falling for the whole last 10 or 15 years. That's normal crime. White-collar crime, we've had an epidemic. And at the top of the epidemic are the bankers. This is an industry that needs a major renovation from top to bottom. And it would be great if some of the big banks actually had one of these I've been saved moments. You know, you get
a conversion
experience. And actually said, we're going to forget about the making huge sums of money for a while. And everybody in this bank is actually going to try to set up a model for the way banks should behave morally and correctly. As far as I can see, none of them are doing that. They're just trying to get as much as they can the same way they always did.
But that's how our system works from the time of Adam Smith, not by the benevolence of the butcher, the brewer, the baker, but with regard to their own self-interest.
That's true, and that's why we have laws to prevent the butcher from giving us poisonous meat. You know, maybe the right solution is a very aggressive police and regulatory process. You know, let's triple the FBI agents looking after them. And let's the FBI agents, you know, do their real FBI stuff, not treat these guys as if they're white-collar masters of the universe, but treat them as they're guys who are trying to rip off the society.
But we're aware of it now.
The government has not really acted. We acted pretty sharply after the savings and loan crisis. We certainly acted in the Great Depression. And when we had other incidents of business behaving insanely, we had Teddy Roosevelt going after the big trusts of that period of time. And for reasons I do not understand, the Congress and the current administration are not acting. Neither the Republicans nor the Democrats seem to have the guts to say, hey, this is an industry we've got to clean up. They're very eager. You know, there's a terrorist attack that they run around doing this. Well, we've had the equivalent of a terrorist attack on our economy. And we still see the terrorists still standing and the average guy without a job. So they should be a little more gutsy about facing down these big banks.
So why haven't the bankers been faced down?
I think they get campaign contributions. I think there are lots of lobbyists in Washington representing the banks. People think, oh, this is a very complicated industry. If we dare upset them, maybe they will destroy our economy.
Or go abroad.
To where? They want to go to Dubai? They want to go to China? Where are they actually going to go? And I think if we set a good high standard of our system is going to be clean, and we're going to make sure our bankers either themselves decide or we force them, they're going to be more honest and more careful of their clients than they have been. I think actually business will come to the country because people will say, oh, I can trust those guys. Whereas now you're sitting there, I think everybody's sitting there and saying, I don't trust them at all. Do you?